Hello there, Despinaire Squad. So I've been on the Design Lab course now for approximately 3.5 weeks. So I've gone through quite a bit of the content and I wanted to sort of give you a bit of a rundown and what I experienced and what I thought of it through that bit. So I've had three out of my four mentor lessons and I can't say like how invaluable those have been to like my progression throughout this course. Like this is definitely the thing that sets this course aside to like any other like just online course that you can learn material through. The Having that mentor, somebody that you can ask questions to and get feedback on your work, like it's imperative. Like, I can't believe how much of a difference it's made on the sort of progression and like design of my work. Like, there are certain things that once I've submitted like assignments and stuff like that, that like the work came back and it was suggested to alter certain things. You might want to think about particular things, look at it. They didn't necessarily, it was definitely self-guidance in terms of like, oh, I think you should change this about your design, I think you should do this and stuff like that, because ultimately that's not going to help me long term. Like, it was more a case of, for argument's sake, think a bit more about how they are aligned within the grid. Think about the margins. Does that size typography work? And sort of tricks to the trade of how to work those sort of things. So it was really, really good. So each every sort, I think it was like 5 to 7 days. I think yeah, every 7 days you got a new section released, which I showed at the beginning of the sort of course. So the first week you go through getting to know design, and then from there, that first week was just sort of going through material understanding, sort of more some of the basics. Not necessarily like it was more, it was of all of the sort of subjects, I found it a little bit tougher to grasp. Because it's not something that is like physically, like for argument's sake, the learning color, learning typography, learning grid, learning layout, they're a little bit more factual. Whereas this is, the getting to know design, I found a little bit harder than the other sections, and it was more people's thoughts on what is design and stuff like that. I have to say the one thing with the Design Lab course, Design 101, which I thought was a little bit interesting, which was a little bit different to sort of what my sort of my idea going in. I thought quite a bit of it would be video based, just due to like all of the online courses that I've taken. But I was pleasantly surprised that quite a bit of it was text-based. So this was like reading through resources, and it was like you get set tasks that you have to read certain articles and to get an understanding. There are videos still in there, and it's within each sort of topic. So for the first week, it was getting to know design. There was two projects within that. And then I'll just click on here now to remind myself of what those two projects were. The first one was to create a product landing page, and the other one was seeing design. So basically, the whole idea, the product landing page was to like, so it was they could get the mentor could get an understanding of your level, what they can see you do currently with the software that you choose to use. I choose to use Sketch in mine just because I feel that's a good software to keep moving forwards in. Like, I feel Photoshop and Illustrator these days aren't fit for purpose for like UX design and moving forwards. But like, Illustrator is definitely something good that I would probably still look to use for like creating icons and that sort and such things like that. But no, it was interesting. Like, I definitely spent quite a bit of time on the first product landing page just to try and prove myself so I could get some good feedback and moving forwards and that kind of thing. I definitely have to say within the first product landing page, like I definitely spent a lot of time on this because my mentor was really good that they helped me really learn a bit more in terms of how to wireframe. Like, I really asked questions that really pushed this my learning through this stage. Because what happens is you have You upload your assignment, so you upload an image of what you've done with your design. So from there, I was really able to they comment on it and give you feedback. So they were suggesting ways to improve. So I actually, since then, I've bought a few sort of things to help me with my sort of sketching. So I've bought some fine tip permanent markers. I've also bought some gray ones for shading, and then also I've got some quite thin paper for helping for the sketches. So it was really good. I did learn loads, and the mentor really was a valuable part to that learning. And then through each week you go, you a new part of the course opens up, and it's only like there's probably only sort of a worth an hour, sort of a day, so 7 hours a week sort of thing. But you can go over more in depth with it should you want to. I definitely did choose in certain sections to really sort of put a lot of effort in and put more in. Like there was one particular section that said only like the guidance is spend around sort of 3 hours. I ended up spending seven. Just really, I was really getting into it and was really learning quite a lot from it. So it was worthwhile me spending more. And since I've got I was working with a good mentor, it was really valuable for me to keep using this time. And I've only got the I'm on this course for a month, so it was really worthwhile me pushing through and learning. I've definitely my sort of found my sort of foundation basics for moving forward have definitely come on loads, and I've got a load more sort of insight and knowledge for sort of moving forwards that will definitely help me whenever I want to sort of create some designs. The sort of the also through the post yesterday I actually got a little gift box off Design Lab, which had a few goodies in, which was a real nice surprise. Which obviously, if you saw me when I first signed up for the enrollment, it said I asked to fill in your sort of details, and obviously that's how they were able to ship me some goodies. So it was a really nice little surprise to get that through the post. I did see there's a sort of a community forum. I did see other people, other students talking about that they'd received there. So I kind of was in the know that this was going to happen. But it was really good. So obviously, like there's got the community forum that there are students asking questions, and you're able to interact a little with the other students. But I was, you can also see other students' work and the comments that the mentors will have left on their work, so you can get a bit of insight, a little bit more knowledge. You don't have to just rely on all of your work. So you can see what other students have sort of published for their projects. And sort of learn a little bit from their feedback as well. You don't just have to use your own, which is really good. You can also comment on each other's work should you want to. But no, it was interesting to see that like I was really happy with some of my designs that I sort of published, and it was interesting to see sort of some other students' design ideas sort of to spark possibly some ideas of my own. But definitely, I'll share with you once I finished the course my final project design. I actually decided to do a sort of a new redesign for my freelancing site. So, using all the knowledge that I'd gained throughout the course, I was able to basically you do this for the last week. I was able to put all this information together that I'd used and gathered, and I was able to get a lot of feedback off the mentor to help sort of shape and get my design to come out looking really well. So hopefully I'll have something really good as well to show for taking the course. The one thing that I will say to you to make the most should you choose to do this course is when you go to your design, to your mentor sessions, they happen once a week and they're scheduled in, is really take some really good questions into the sessions. This will really maximize the time that you spend speaking with your mentor. These sessions last for just around an hour, so it's you really want to make sure you use the time as best as you can. There was a few times that I might not have had some good enough questions to fill out the whole time, but the mentor did a really good job of like keeping the conversation going and me maximizing my time throughout there. So that would be my only one thing, is that especially when starting the course, I scheduled my first set, sort of first call with my mentor, basically the next day after starting the course. And the only one thing that I found with this was that I hadn't gone through any of the course content at this point, so I didn't really have really any questions. So my main thing would be, if you are going to take this course, is really work through sort of the first section of content, really get some questions outlined for your call, for your mentor. But I think one of the things is that, having done a bit of design already, I might not have had as many questions to ask as compared to somebody who was completely new. So I think that was one of the other issues. There was definitely that I didn't have naturally all these questions cropping up. But I definitely, so far, recommend this course. It's definitely been a very valuable asset to me, sort of thing. And for only sort of $299, and with the discount code that Design Lab hook you up with, it's really good. And you also come out with something that you can use. Like, I decided to make my sort of final project a little personal sort of site that I can use. So it's really going to benefit me even more. So I will share that design in the sort of the blog post, so you can see something that I've worked on throughout this course. And I would recommend it so far to anybody. I've got my last call with my mentor tonight, and then I'll sort of do a bit of a wrap up summary of this course. And again, if you do have any questions regarding this sort of course, just drop them in the comments of the blog post, and I'll do my best to answer these. There's a few people that saying that had some questions, and I've personally answered them via email. But there was a few people commenting on YouTube video as well, and definitely sort of recommending the course, and a few students have already enrolled off the back of this, so it'll be really great to see what they're able to build off the back of this. But no, definitely recommending it. It's a good course to work with, and I'll speak to you guys after I've had my last mentor session, and I'll share with you what my overall opinion of the course is. I'll speak to you guys soon. Bye.